Hi everyone, let's go through revision of partial fractions topic today. I'll be covering two main subtopics. One is related to improper rational fraction and one is related to repeated factors. So resolve this improper fraction into partial fractions. How do we call that this is an improper fraction? First, we will have to look at the degree of the numerator. Degree is nothing but the power, right? Degree is nothing but the power of x. So the degree here is 2. For numerator, it is 2. Denominator also it is 2. So if degree of numerator is equal to or greater than degree of denominator, then it is an improper fraction. So now in this case, the degree of the numerator and denominator is same. Therefore, it is an improper fraction. Now what we have to do is we will have to divide. So we have to divide it this way. So we will have to multiply something with this value x square so that you get x square. So we'll have to multiply with 1. So x square into 1 is x square, right? Then we'll have to multiply plus x into 1 is plus x, minus 12 into 1 is minus 12. Now we'll have to subtract the whole thing. So x square and x square will get cancelled. So what is the value that we get? We get quotient is 1. So we will have to put the quotient here and add it with the remainder. Remainder we have is minus 6 plus 10, or we can write this as 10 minus x. 10 minus x by whatever we divided it with. So x square plus x minus 12. So let's remember to put this 1 here. So this is the quotient. This is the remainder. And this one is the divisor. Now what we will do next is we will just take this portion. We'll resolve it into partial fractions. And then finally we add 1 to it. So we have this fraction here, 10 plus x by x square plus x minus 12. Now we'll have to split this into factors, right? We'll have to get it in this form. To split it into factors, we have to use sum product method. There are two methods to do it. One is sum product method and one is a formula method. That is, we can use it. We can use this formula, which is minus b, b square plus or minus 4ac by 2a. We can use this formula, right, or use a sum product method. One of these methods we can use to get the factors. Now in this video, I'll go through sum product method. In the sum product method, we'll have to take this. We'll have to find the product and sum. Product is nothing but you multiply this number minus 12 with the coefficient of x square. What is coefficient of x square? Is 1. Basically, the number next to x square is the coefficient of x square. So we have to multiply minus 12 and 1. So minus 12 into 1 is minus 12. Right, then we have to get the sum. What is the sum? It is the coefficient of x. Coefficient of x is 1 here, because it's nothing, we assume it is 1. So 1. We will have to choose two numbers whose product is minus 12, and if you add those two numbers, you should get 1. Now there are multiple combinations, so you'll get 4 and 3. If you multiply 4 and 3, you'll get 12. You take 6 and 2 also, you'll get 12. If you take 12 into 1 also, you'll get 12. But at the same time, when you add these numbers, you should get 1 as the answer. 4 and 3 seems to be a right one. So if I take 4 and 3 as the two numbers, 4 into 3 is 12, but I need a negative sign. So one of the numbers should have a minus sign. So I'll assume that 3 is going to have a minus sign. Now I'll have to take the same numbers and add them. So if I add 4 and 3, I should get 1. So here I put minus to the 3. So 3 as minus, so 4 minus 3 becomes 1. So this condition is satisfied. The product condition is satisfied. The sum condition is also satisfied. Therefore, the numbers are 4 and minus 3. And then we'll have to write it as x plus 4 because it's plus 4 and x minus 3 because it's minus 3. So these are the factors for this expression. So now we will substitute this expression with x plus 4 and x minus 3 since they are the factors. Now we will write, we will split this entire fraction like this. We'll say a by x plus 4 and b by x minus 3. So one factor here and one factor here. So now what I'm going to do is multiply both the sides by x plus 4 and x minus 3. So if I'm going to multiply both the sides, what's going to happen is here it's going to be x plus 4 into x minus 3 and these are multiplied here. So this and this is going to get cancelled. X plus 4 is going to get cancelled. X minus 3 is going to get cancelled. So I'll be left with 10 minus x is equal to a into x minus 3 plus b into x plus 4. So now as a next step, we'll have to put x is equal to 3. So here x minus 3 is there, right? We'll have to put x is equal to, we'll have to take the opposite sign. We'll have to put x is equal to 3. And then we substitute x is equal to 3 throughout this expression and we'll get the value for b. Next step is we'll put x is equal to minus 4. Because it is plus 4 here, you'll assume you'll put x is equal to minus 4 and you'll get a. Now we'll have to substitute a and b. A is minus 2 and b is 1 and we get this. So we'll have to go to the first equation that we had got here, right? After division, we had got this. We had got the quotient, remainder and the divisor. So now we'll have to substitute this. We'll have to substitute this fraction into the first equation. So we have the quotient as 1 and instead of this fraction, we have minus 2 by x plus 4 plus 1 by x minus 3, which we got by resolving this expression, this fraction. Let's go to another example where we have to resolve partial fractions where there are repeated factors. Repeated factors means where you have these powers, right? X plus 3 the whole square, x plus 3 the whole cube. So when you have repeated factors like this, we will have to use another additional step to find the fractions. So now first thing is we are going to split this. How we are going to split it? A by x plus 3, we'll take 1 with power 1, then b by x plus 3 with power 2, and then c by x plus 4. Now you multiply both the sides by x plus 3 the whole square, that is you multiply both the sides with this term. So when you multiply both the sides, what are you going to get? You're going to multiply this left hand side with x plus 3 the whole square and x plus 4. So we'll multiply all of these fractions into x plus 3 the whole square and x plus 4. So what's going to happen? X plus 3 and x plus 3 is going to get cancelled. We are left with 1 x plus 3, right? Similarly, it will get cancelled. And so we are going to get expression like this, right? Now we'll have to put x is equal to minus 3 here, right? And then next we'll have to put x is equal to minus 4. So we'll get the values for b and values for c. But how do we get the value for a? Because we already put x as minus 3 and x is minus 4. Now what do we do for a? In such cases, we'll need to add the coefficients of x square. Add the coefficients of x square. How do we get the coefficients of x square? Come to the main equation, right? This is the main equation. This is the main equation. Coefficient of x square. So when you multiply this and this, you're going to get x square. And what is that? It's going to be x square. What is the coefficient? 1. And for b, there is no x square at all. So coefficient is 0. For c, so x plus 3 the whole square. That is nothing but x plus 3 into x plus 3. When you multiply x into x, you're going to get x square. What is the coefficient? 1. There is nothing, so it's 1. So coefficients are 1 and 1, right? And what is the coefficient for x square on the left-hand side? It's 2. 2 is a coefficient. So what we are going to do now is, 2 was the coefficient here for x square. 1 was for the first fraction. For the term b, there was no coefficient. And for c, it was 1. So now we substitute the value of c that we got, right? We got c as minus 3. C is minus 3. And we are going to get the value for a here, right? A is 5. Now we'll substitute all a, b, c values in the expression. So with this, I've come to the end of revision for partial fractions. It's a simple chapter and we can easily score marks in this particular topic. Thanks for watching.